let's have the first slide. I'm Dave Clark, and there's going to be a picture here. This was, it didn't gonna do me any good. Yeah, I can get off camera. But, so I know this thing goes back about 30 years, and this is the first time I've really heard it. And all I've heard is a couple of wimpy cuts on it, so we'll see what we can do. Okay, I have a very short slideshow, mainly for my own use to tell me what to mention. These are all the speakers that we want to measure the frequency response of and everything using PTF. Now, the PTF is... just a collection of microphone positions, like actually eight of them that are averaged together. And that's like what it does for you is it, it's sort of like water ripples in a fish tank or something. If you measure in eight places and average them together, you know how much the water level really is. If you look at any one, it doesn't give you all the information. So it's a good way of measuring, and we measured all these things. Then it was time to adjust the DCX 2496s. These are the subwoofer things. Electronics, equalization, crossover points, slope, equalization, time delay, equalization of systems. Now, I allowed quite a bit of time for this, but it wasn't nearly enough, and... So I've learned the route over here down I-94 and so forth. Next slide. Same slide, different slide. So we found out that one of the two microphones that moves to four positions on the PTF didn't work, and pretty well determined that it's a software problem and just gave up. And so we had to use only four mic positions, and basically what you should do is move the whole head apparatus, which is this, to a couple of different locations that you think are important. We did that and found out that Mark Ziemba's chair has no base. And so... You've had enough bass in your life,
I've had enough bass. I heard the JBLs before. I'm fine.
Yeah. Okay.
And to be for Dave's, the fact that where that's critical is in a car with your left ear right against here, you'd have to have that working. But in a room, no big deal.
Yeah. Okay.
So, and it's only between 40 and 80 hertz that there's no bass.
Well,
below 40 and above, it's kind of okay.
Yeah. Like everywhere that rock and roll is important. There's nothing there. Yeah, right. I can get that for a lot less money and effort than this thing. Miscellaneous audio problems, Bob's problems. First one's my problems. Resorted to front panel control of the DCXs, the equalizers, which I considered to be like caveman style of equalizing compared to doing it with the GUI. The good news is that Bob had previously EQ'd this with a single mic, I guess just in the center of the room, and it looked pretty good. And so since we're out of time, that's essentially what we just checked with the four positions of the PTF.
That was back in the days when the serial port control did work. And that was the previous work was done with Room 8 Blizzard.
Next slide, please. Oh. Yeah. Or the next presentation, please. Okay, so for example, this is, I removed everything else from the graph to simplify it, but this is the a pair of woofers response. And this is the equivalent of sine waves in a room, 12th octave analysis. And you can see that they probably, the truth is somewhere in the middle of all this, but that's far less spread than you would get with one microphone. You'd get, you know, plus or minus 15 or 20 dB things. So that's BTF. Next slide. I only have two of these, but that shows one driver. This shows them all put together. I don't know what goes on right here. We didn't dig into that, but basically you can see it goes pretty much from the left side to the right side without too much vertical, and that's what you want in a frequency response.
Why do you get seven decimal points of accuracy on two? I mean, could you round that to 315 instead of 314.9?
I can, but the software can't.
This is software.
The world of Excel. So you've got plus 5, plus 6 down there in the below 32 range, and you've only got minus 8 or so at the 8,000 to 12,000. What's that all about? What are you talking about? Minus 5 or 6. We've got 12 octaves all the way from...
What he's talking about, Dave, is why, explain why, for when it sounds good, is the 8,000 to 20,000 down about 5 dB.
Oh, I see, I see. Just,
that's what he's saying. Okay,
okay. Thanks for the lead-in. empirically, it's been determined that this is preferable. And I could explain why, but it would take till tomorrow for me to convince all of you.
But Bob Schuline had a paper that talked about this in a big room, a sound reinforcement thing.
Yeah. Well, you always have to have more. The bigger the room, the more you have to turn down the treble.
Well, Bob, I think, had some good ideas, and this foam and these sideways microphones actually are inspired by Bob's paper 40 years ago or whatever. But I think he spoke a little too much. I think that there's fundamentally a simpler explanation. But at any rate, this is considered a very good response. And so that's what we'll be listening. Now, another type of measurement, was to use the scope that's a three-channel oscilloscope or four-channel oscilloscope. We're using three of the four. And the channel number one, yellow, is the displacement of one of the four cones. And it's actually calibrated, and you can read out how far it goes. Now, on this screen, fully top and fully bottom is plus 40 millimeters and minus 40 millimeters. Wow. So if we see it move, it's moving. And the next one is the amplifier power to drive it. And it goes from plus 80 volts to minus 80 volts. And so if we really push it, you can use up most of that. And so if we play sine waves, you'll see a sine wave. And this channel, pink channel, is the acoustic output from a microphone that's in that head, just amplified by this thing and plugged into the scope. And I don't have an SBL calibration, but it could be calibrated for SBL, it just isn't. And we'll adjust it if we have to. So, Bob, why don't you play either your favorite work of art, the Heathkit Oscillator, or or some organ music, or whatever floats its boat, as you say. And we'll look at the traces and watch them wiggle. And that's basically the end of my...
Music.
Not organ music.
I think that's the end of my presentation, except for questions. So, Bob, it's all yours.
Let's see now. What frequency would you like me to start?
5. What's your best frequency?
Hum is the best place. 60 is the best place to start, and then go down. Yeah. Everybody knows what hum sounds like, and I'm not going to hear it anyway. So that's good.
Yeah, you're in the no bass chair.
Yeah, exactly. I love 10. That's nice.
Your
woofers, the woofers are only doing about 10 millimeters there, right, David? Plus or minus 10.
Yeah, plus or minus 10.
But that's because he's got such a low volume.
Sorry.
I'm just teasing you.
That gives him
at
2 meters.
That'd be a great car simulator.
Here's 16.
What's the pick one?
That's the power.
Acoustic.
Oh, acoustic, sorry.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Acoustic,
okay. Here's me. He's going to recalibrate it. That's not calibrated for SBI.
Certain ones.
That's what he said.
He's
trying to get about the same amount.
My hearing condition is that I can't tolerate certain loud sounds.
This is 8 hertz.
Pressure related, but TV.
Yeah, the TV's moving, Bob. Look at this lampshade.
That's a passive radiator.
Yeah, forget about the windows.
You found the first rock.
Well, those plastic sheets of DLP.
Five.
TVs are pretty flimsy anyhow.
It's not like glass.
Yeah, it's not glass.
That's 4 hertz. It's everything starts to roll off in this system.
Let me mention
something. With the help of Arnie and a Behringer codec, USB stereo input, stereo output interface, sound card interface kind of thing, I had to check everything, including the sound card itself, for where does it roll off? Right. Well, it turns out the measurement device itself is down 1 dB at 5 hertz.
Right.
The lexicon is down 1 dB at 6 hertz. The Behringers are down a dB and a quarter, dB and a half at 5 hertz. The Rain ME30 and SP15, even when they're modified, are down a fraction of a dB at 5 hertz because I had control over that because I modified them.
Right.
The Behringer power amps are down almost 3 dB at 5 hertz. Right. So you're coming into this, and then all of a sudden, everything's just rolling off.
Because that's protecting.
Yeah.
Protecting people.
I see you've got an auditor over there flying on the wall.
Well, it's a June bug, or a little ladybug.
Okay, so why don't you give me 20 hertz, and I'll show the last trick for this puppy, but just at a medium level.
That's medium.
Yeah, a little higher. That's good. Okay, now what we're going to do is...
That bad?
Yeah, but what's hammer?
Well, I have to remodel the house.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, that's cool, Dave. That's FFT built into it?
Yeah, so this is the fundamental and all of the harmonics acoustically that the microphone is picking up and is rattling. And they're showing 10 or 5, 10, 15, no, twice that, 10, 20,
30,
about 30 dB down.
Which for is a second harmonic.
0.3%
That's stupendous.
Second, third, and all this. The fact that there's any second is just due to an imbalance. Should be canceling seconds, but third is inevitable.
And it's also the house. It's the structure is not is making sense.
So you can. Well, there's no point in running at a higher level. Just the harmonics are going up, and they get a little bit higher. But at lower level, well, they should go even lower. Let's try that. It takes a while for this thing to refresh, to rethink.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
10, 20, 30. No, it's about the same.
But the third one, way down.
Third one way down, yeah. Yeah, same imbalance still exists, but the third one's way down. So it gets a little cleaner as you drop the level.
But that's stupendously clean for 20 hertz out of a subwoofer.
Oh, yeah, that's outrageous. That's really good.
Really outrageous. I mean, there is no commercial subwoofer that can even get into the zip code.
Unless you go to a FICAR and put it in a car like it was designed for.
Well, I'm talking a commercial in the box.
Yeah.
I just got a SVS subwoofer in that is able to do 110 dB at 10 hertz.
And that's the best you've seen yet?
Yes.
Yeah. What is that retail for?
I think it's $899 or something like that.
$899?
Wow.
Fairly
how much?
$899, I think.
Really?
It's the SVS people from Ohio.
Mm-hmm. And what size driver is it?
It's a 13-inch.
Mm-hmm. That's a strange.
And this is at 2 meters.
Right, right. But still, that's a
big box.
Okay, give me the 20 hertz again.
No, there's a long box, actually.
I'll flip to see. Let's see. That's okay, so that's a 20 hertz. I'll just leave it on the screen so that...
They flogged their Chinese supplier a little harder.
Well, in fact...
As a matter of fact, one of the guys, I don't know if he's still there, but he used to work at DLC.
Yeah, they sold out. All the guys are gone.
Are they? Okay.
Yeah. Were Alpine gone?
No, SVS.
And where are they from, Ohio?
Yeah, okay, so I'll leave that there and you can play a record of it.
You're saying they had a change of staff?
Well, somebody else.
Oh, yeah, they were sold. They bought out.
Oh, who bought
them? Sold out.
Some private investment?
Yeah, some corporation. Who
yeah, well, they're still doing good subwoofers.
Oh, yeah. Now they're doing the whole theater system complete.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, they got a lot of other
options. Yeah, they have full-range speakers.
Yeah.
And didn't SVS use Bash amplifiers and stuff for their power?
Yeah.
Ramp it up? Yeah. I already said that my part of this is over, so I think this concludes the formal meeting, unless we're going to... watch, I'm getting a 5, and I'm getting
This program has been a production of the Southeastern Michigan Woofer and Tweeter Marching Society. Opinions expressed during this program are those of the individual speaking and not necessarily the opinion of the Southeastern Michigan Woofer and Tweeter Marching Society.